that the state has created to spot, nurture, and make startup out of you, make startup out of an idea. So I'm glad that we are part of it officially, which means the state government has recognized that Ganpat University can go ahead and inspire young people, spot them, see their ideas, and create an ecosystem where they can become tomorrow's, maybe not Google, but good startups. For every Google and Microsoft, there are so many other startups who are doing well, and now we have our own brand of Snapdeal to Flipkart, all kinds of startups, whose valuation is now 1 lakh crore. If Flipkart's valuation is more than Tata Motors, if Uber's valuation, which has not even one car, more than Ford Motors and others, I think what prevents you from doing so? It is not like yesteryears, not like Ganpat, we were to put up a brick and mortar facility, buy. So typically startup when, I think Pawan Bhai and I started, was the time when we had to actually go to our fathers or father-in-law, as the case may be, that bhai paise chahiye kuch. Hai na? Land buy karni hai. So that we won't buy land and then we want to construct factory and then maybe create a Tata Motors at the end of maybe second or third generation, and then tomorrow somebody like you would come over and in 10 years create an enterprise which would have valuation of at least 10,000 crore more than Tata Motors had after so many years of existence and hard work and money of fathers-in-law. You are the ones who have that opportunity. And the very fact that you have come here, and if out of this talk and today's deliberations, if we can inspire 10 or 15 minds out of here to start a startup, I think I would consider it a privilege for all of us. I'm going to talk today about two small aspects, because I think we have lineup of people like Prashant Bhai, who's only doing startup. I think all of us are doing part-time, but he's only engaged in that. We have seven guys who have actually done it, who have walked that way. We are only perhaps investors or inspirers, but they are the ones who have perspired. So I think we have lineup of people who are going to talk about how to make a startup work. I'm going to talk about why you should go on this path of startup and who should go on a path of startup. So these two small points that I would touch and then lead you to more exciting presentations throughout the day. One is as to who, and I'm going to relate this to a current startup that I'm advising, which is by a young friend about 26 years old who's putting up an online game playing portal. And therefore I'm relating it because he and I are in those questions today as to who is the right person for startup. Because so many boys that I meet, and in Power of Ideas, I think when I was talking about it, one guy said that, how do I know whether I am the startup material or not? Which means that, am I the guy? To answer that question, I look at it through a couple of lenses or filters, if you may. One is that, are you between 20 and 40? One is that age group. Though Ganpat Bhai also can do a startup and so can I, but I think we are better off signing checks and supporting you than doing it ourselves. I think 20, because less than 20 also there are, I think, people who have started at 18, but I think 20 is a good age to think about startup and start living it. And 40, I think, is the age by which I would not advise people to do startup, but I, in Lead Angels, I think we see about 3 proposals every month looking for angel investment for startup, and very rarely I come across somebody who's 35, 40, 45. But after 40, you don't want to take all the risks, you don't want to lose your shirt because you have liabilities at home, you have children, and you are no longer that guy who's wanting to work so much. So a startup requires, and there are many startups who tell us that almost for 4 years, 3-4 years, there's no other life which exists for them. They're working up to 3 a.m., they are living their passion, they are living that madness where they can't date a girl, where they can't locate a prospective father-in-law, where they don't have family dinners. They are almost living their lives through their startup. So that at an age of 40 becomes difficult because there are natural opposition to that from the spouse and from the children. So I feel that 40 is very much my line of cutoff. So I think if you are 20 to 40 and in this room, other than people who are sitting here, I think all qualify, sir. So that is first, you know, one that you need to be in that. And second is, as to who does that, I think if you have some pain point that you are ready to address, which means that how can you do a startup unless you have some solution? And if you don't have that solution, please don't do it because it doesn't make sense. Are you going through an experience of life which sucks, which you feel you have a solution for? Because this is what you don't think people should go through. Do you have that? So if you have that, and this young boy that I am talking to and we're creating that startup is the one who says that all the online playing sites suck. Which means that he says that there is a huge elated experience if you play in a different manner. So he has that. He plays it all the time and now he feels that this is not the way. It's like some Uber thinking that no. Why there are so many people traveling, they need to go through the rigmarole of a taxi and if there is a better solution. So he found one. So I think if you're open and if you're not, please look for it. Please be a solution provider. Please look at something that distresses you, which means that right now you don't have any solution. Please take up a project together. And that project would give you an idea that you have some solution there. So look at that. Third is as to who should do it. I feel that the right place is a person who is at the university or who has just gotten out of it. So in that sense, Ganpat University, I think, is the right place, and government of Gujarat has rightly recognized university to be that place where a startup can happen. So if you are 20 to 40, if you have an idea that you think addresses pain points, and if you are young at university, do that. That is who part of it. Now why? This young man was telling me that I'm doing so well playing the game. Should I go through the pains of forming a company? He says, I don't like, sorry for saying this, lawyers, I don't like advocates, I don't like paperwork, I don't like business part of it. I like playing. So should I go through these pains of creating a company which would entail maybe a lot of work which he would not like? I think all of us have that. We are passionate about some ideas, we like it, but it has some aspects which we don't like. That is where startup gives you an opportunity, because most of the startups are not by one person. We learned SME enterprise, small and medium or ultra small in IIM Ahmedabad, when my professor was always telling me that small enterprise means it is one man show. It is one man show. So that's hammered in my mind. But I think startup, refreshingly differently, always means group. I have rarely come across a startup which is just by one person. So you have group because there is one person who is passionate about an idea or solution he has, and he is backed by friends who are passionate about businesses, lawyers, documentation, marketing, business part of it, what the customer wants, how to get customers. Somebody who is looking at other aspects, somebody who is number crunching and who understands money, that we are getting only this much and we need to spend less than that. So somebody who understands that different part of it. So why should you do it? Because it gives you an opportunity. When I recently concluded a reunion of our batch at IIM Ahmedabad, and I've been with the alumni association of IIM Ahmedabad. So I know that nostalgia which happens when you meet after 30 years, 25 years, no joy can compare with that. However much you might be an Ajay Banga who has made it big in MasterCard and with others, but when you are among friends, I think some of the happiest moments just occur. Startup would give you that. Maybe you can do your business and make so much money, but startup allows you to be with your friends for work. So that fun becomes work, and actually you get to know a person much more by being friend with him just for 2 days and maybe one dinner versus a corporate which would interview a guy and try to know whether this CEO is right for you or not. So it is easier for a startup to find a co-founder because you have had a cup of tea with him and gone out on dinner or gone with disco. So you have opportunities to explore that person as a co-founder, which you don't get with somebody who you interview for a position of CEO. So startup gives you an opportunity to work with your friends, to be with your friends. I think none of us would like anything more than to hang out with friends. Here you hang out with friends on the work and create something which is meaningful. So you must do startup because, and third is that startup allows you to live life very intensely. Very, very intensely. A very packed life. I think what you would do as almost 10, 15 years of salary job, you would do in 3 years in a startup. You would put all your energy in it. You would put all your waking hours. There are startups who are promoted, and I think we all know who would put in 12, 15, 16 hours every day in their startup. So you would almost live 10 years in that 3 years that you would have a startup. Very intense. You would almost not do anything. And good thing about startup is it's like an exam, you know. You get a result very fast. Maybe 1 or 2 years and you have passed or you fail. And that's all right. You're young. You've tried. And I have seen that more than a person can learn as an MBA, one can learn much more if you have spent 2 years actually working on a startup, even if it failed. And therefore, I feel that though we must all together work on how to make that 2-3 out of 10 startup to succeed, if we can say jump it to maybe 5 or 6, that would be great. But even while we don't do it, I think those 7 or 8 or 6 who fail learn so much out of it. I have individually learned so much out of my failures and my successes. So every startup which fails creates a very competent manager, CEO, who can really go out in corporate world and make a contribution. I urge you to try what is the best out of you. It is like that Maslow's hierarchy of needs, the ultimate one, which is self-actualization, which says that each individual must be what he or she can be. That is the stage of self-actualization, which is the ultimate satisfaction that all of us can promise ourselves. I would urge you to go for it. Go for what you can become. And welcome to the world of startups. Thank you so much.